The local rickshaw pullers took some time to start believing in SMB Wheels, but it is a word-of-mouth business and they soon saw the benefit of joining up. There are an estimated 10 million rickshawwalas in India and 95% of them rent their vehicles from mafia-like fleet merchants, saving nothing in the bargain. But with SMB Wheels, they're finally able to put some money aside for themselves.
पहले रिक्शा किराए पे चलाते थे, जब हमको मालूम चला यहाँ पर 30 मिल रहा है गाड़ी 300 का हफ्ता, तब मैंने सोचा कि किराए पे क्यों चलाऊं, अगर अपना हो जाएगा, अगर साल भर देना है तो साल भर के बाद अपना कोई हो जाएगा, तो फिर 300 का कौन बड़ी चीज है, और साल भर के बाद अपना ही हो जाएगा। इनके लिए पढ़ाई पर सोच रहे हैं, पढ़ लिख लिख लें, अपना फिर आगे भविष्य अपना देखेंगे। आज एक रिक्शा लिए हैं, और सर साल भर में दो ठेले ले, हम तीन ठेले ले, और हमारे पास बढ़ोतरी समय पर हमारा सहारा रहेगा ये ना।
So tell us a little bit about Munna Lal, for example, and how his life changed after this.
See, Munna Lal, when he came to our office, he was very depressed, and actually the fleet merchant, he has given him some beating because he was not able to pay and he was ill. So he came and he began to cry that, see, I have been flying the rickshaw from past 5 years, but still that guy, you know, had not exempted me from the rent. One day rent itself. So I said that no issues, and if you want, we can help you, and you, if you want, we can give you a rickshaw. So then Munna Lal Sonkar become the member of SMV, and now he's going to become the owner of the rickshaw. His family, the kid was not able to go to the school, but now he's sending his kid to the school, and they're living a good life.
So apart from the fact that you do manage to give them ownership of the rickshaws in itself, what are some of the other plans you have to bring in revenues through this entire venture?
See, so apart from giving them the ownership and the vocational services, as I mentioned, like insurance, legal licenses, photo ID cards, to minimize the harassment and, you know, and to give the dignity to this profession. The other revenue sources which we are trying to develop is tourism rickshaw. So we are trying to develop a device with, you know, with the support of Stanford University, on which the tourist can come, and they can, while going to a place, to a destination, they can learn about the history of the place, and so you have a better understanding of the place which you are visiting. So that way the revenue can be earned. The major part of the revenue we plan to get from the advertisements on the back side of the rickshaw. So we are reaching major corporates for that. And in fact, we are also trying to, you know, build some ancillary products like selling the water bottles, newspapers, and cold drinks to the customers.
Do you charge interest on the actual loan to the auto rickshaws, or the fact that they're paying on installments? Is that also an interest earning there?
So see, basically we have a top up of 10% over the whole thing. So there is no interest of that kind.
Okay.
And we sell the rickshaw on the installment basis. So weekly installment. So they have to pay like 300 rupees per week for 52 weeks.
So the revenue is not from that. The revenue is going to be from the additional.
Yes, you can say a small chunk of revenue comes from there.
Okay.
But the major source of revenue
is going to be from. Okay. So what is the kind of potential you see for this business over the next few years? It's only been about a year and a half so far, and of course from the basic ownership model, it's a very marginal revenue that you're going to see. So one part of it, I'm assuming, is scale. So I want to understand your ambitions in terms of taking this further and outside of Varanasi. And the other part, of course, is the kind of potential you see for those add-on services in terms of revenue.
So see, basically, in coming 5 years, we plan to reach 20,000 rickshaw pullers itself in the state of UP. And already we have been opened a branch outside Varanasi recently in Jaunpur, in the city of Jaunpur. And we are doing good there also. So we have sold like 200 rickshaws in last couple of months in Jaunpur. If you look at the vision of the company, so we want to be number one company in the cycle rickshaw space in the coming decade. And we work and we believe to make the rickshaw pullers of today the entrepreneurs of tomorrow. Yes.
Looking at, of course, spreading your wings across India in some time. You know, some people argue that cycle rickshaws are going to go out of fashion or go out of business very soon. I mean, they used to say that even about auto rickshaws a while ago, and that hasn't happened yet. But what would be your, you know, argument or logic when it comes to that allegation when it comes across?
I will share a very truth incident with you on this. So what happened that Delhi High Court, they banned the rickshaws, you know, on the main roads.
Yeah.
But while the metros were initiated in the city, then the cycle rickshaws become the metro feeder in the colony. So the artery roads are now, they are the feeders from the metro station to the nearby colony. The rickshaw numbers have increased by 10 to 15% instead of, you know, going down.
Okay.
Because of that order. And so I don't think that cycle rickshaws are going to be ever, you know, eliminated from the roads, because at one time these bigger cities are growing bigger, the infrastructure is increasing, but the smaller cities are also becoming bigger. And rickshaw, cycle rickshaw is a kind of lifestyle of people in northern India especially. So if you have to buy a vegetable or you have to go for a small ride, you feel that it's your own space. So and it reaches to your house, to the same destination. Unlike autos, they take you from point to point from the main road, but the artery feeder is only the cycle rickshaw. So I don't think it's ever going to be eliminated from that.
We take a very quick break here on the show. When we come back, we also take a closer look at how Dastra is involved in enabling this change to take place.